I welcome you all to 25th lecture of this course. Now, before I start today's topic, there are a few announcements. The first one is related to your assignment 4. So today in the evening, I'll try to send you assignment 4. Now, this time I'll give you more time to submit assignment. So today is 17th. The due date for assignment 4 is 28th after the puja vacation. So 28th October by 12th night, you submit your assignment. Okay. And I'll be sending the instruction also to the ERP mail regarding the assignment. Now the second announcement, that is regarding your next class. Now, I think there are a few dual degree students, and the grand viva for the dual degree students has been scheduled from 19th to 21st October. That is from coming Monday. So I have decided not to take the class on 21st. So the next class of this course will be held on 28th October after the puja vacation, that is Wednesday, and we are going to start at 12. Okay, so on 21st, I'm not going to take your class because some of you might be busy with your dual degree grand viva. Okay, so I've decided to take your next class on 28th October. Okay. Now with this, let me start with today's topic, that is self-organizing math, that is in short known as SOM, and this is also popularly known as Cohonent Network. Now this is known as Cohonent Network according to the name of the proposer, that Dr. Cohonent. And Dr. Cohonent actually proposed this self-organizing math in the year around 1995 as his PhD thesis. Now, I had the opportunity to meet him once in Japan in 2000. And in that particular conference, Dr. Cohonent mentioned that although I proposed this particular technique about 94-95. So this particular technique has been modified in a number of ways. And in 2000, he mentioned that it has become difficult for me now to keep track. And in time, a large number of papers published using the principle of self-organizing math. A very large number of papers has been published. Okay. The reason behind that popularity, I'm going to tell you. Okay. Now, the self-organizing map or the Cohonent network, it can be used as a visualization technique or dimensionality reduction technique. Now, while discussing the principle of dimensionality reduction technique, I mentioned that self-organizing math might be the most powerful one out of all the available techniques, okay, for dimensionality reduction. Like from higher dimension to two dimension or three dimension for the purpose of visualization, okay. And this is a topology preserving tool. So it preserves not only the distance, but also the topology. So it is going to preserve the topology of this particular, the surface. Now let me take the example which I took in my previous class also, the very popular example according to me. Now, it suddenly came to my mind, the method which we follow in the exam hall during the examination. Okay, now let me repeat. I already took the example, but let me repeat it. Supposing that you are in the exam hall. The moment you get the question paper, say there are 10 questions in the question paper, you are going to concentrate how to give answer to question number one. You read question number one at least once or might be twice or thrice. Okay. And now you are going to write down the answer to question number one. Now, whenever you are writing the answer to question number one, there is every possibility that you will be referring back to the class notes, or you'll be referring back to my NPTEL lectures or this particular lecture or my textbook. Okay, supposing that you are referring to my textbook. The moment you are writing the answer to question number one, your brain will automatically go to that page of the textbook where you find the related answer. Might be it is on the odd side page of the textbook or on the even side textbook, or there is every possibility you will remember my lecture and my face while writing that particular answer to question number one. How does it happen? How can you remember the topology of that particular your textbook? That answer to question number one might be available on the odd side page of the textbook on soft computing written by Professor Pratyal. How can you remember? You can remember because your brain works based on the topology preserving tool. Okay, so your brain has got both the capability, the distance preserving tool as well as the topology preserving tool. And you will be astonished to listen. Most of the time, your brain works based on the self-organizing map. What is the reason? The reason is very simple, because it works based on the principle of unsupervised and competitive learning. Now, remember one thing, getting the known input-output data for most of the real-world problem is quite impossible. Are you getting my point? But still, your brain will have to work. Your brain will have to take the decision to solve that particular the problem. How can it do it? It can do because it uses the principle of unsupervised and competitive learning. Okay, so it does not take care of your supervised learning adopted through incremental learning or the batch mode of training. Okay, and I'm just going to discuss the principle of this unsupervised learning, and you'll be astonished to listen that knowingly or unknowingly, you people are doing exactly the same thing. Okay, most probably you do not know. Okay, now I'll be discussing in detail the principle of your unsupervised learning. Let me take another very practical example which suddenly came to my mind. Okay, now you people are at home, but you remember the first day when you came to IIT Kharagpur hostel. Try to go back. Try to remember the experience of that first day. You see, IIT Kharagpur, most probably the campus was unknown to you. Okay, and if you try to remember the first day schedule was very hectic. Okay, so your friends were unknown. This place, this campus were unknown. Your academic building, your hostel, everything were unknown. You are in real trouble. If you remember the first day at IIT Kharagpur campus, okay, but gradually you could overcome that particular problem, okay, and came to know the different like departments, the different facilities available in the campus, okay, and that will help you to get habituated with the campus of IIT Kharagpur. How does it happen? Who was there to help you in each and every the problem you faced? There is nobody, in fact. Okay, such a large number of students are coming. So if 1900 students are coming on the first day, can I get 1900 people here to assist all 1900 students? It is quite impossible. Okay, so what you did, you are using your own head, own brain, your own self-organizing math. You people did not know that time, and your self-organizing math helped you to overcome many problems, and gradually you became habituated with the campus of IIT Kharagpur. You could solve that particular problem. It is due to the self-organizing map, and your brain works based on the self-organizing map. Okay, how does it work? I'll be discussing. But before that, let me tell you, if the higher dimension data, I can map it to the lower dimension. I have got the information in lower dimension. Now, based on the similarity, the way I discuss the clustering algorithm, I can also do the clustering. Okay, and that is why the self-organizing map along with clustering is a very efficient tool for carrying out the clustering problem. Okay, to solve the clustering problem, self-organizing map is found to be very efficient. Okay, now don't concentrate on this particular figure for the time being. I'll once again come back and I'll tell you. Okay. But before that, let me just proceed to the next. It is a non-linear generalization of principal component analysis, PCA. Regarding the PCA, I have already told you that PCA is the most popular the tool for linear mapping, 1:1 mapping. But whenever you are doing the mapping from higher dimension to lower dimension, you cannot expect 1:1 mapping. So you'll have to do some sort of nonlinear mapping. And that is why the self-organizing map is nothing but nonlinear generalization of principal component analysis. I hope I'm clear to all of you. And you'll see construction-wise, this particular, the self-organizing map, this neural network, it consists of only two layers. Okay, I'll be coming to that structure. So it consists of input layer and competition layer. I'll be discussing in detail. And on the competition layer, there are three basic operations, namely competition, cooperation, and updating. This is very interesting. And I'll tell you, in the course of soft computing, this particular idea is the most complicated one.
Excuse me.
Please.
Yes. Are you on slide 7?
I am on slide 7. Okay.
So it's showing slide 6, sir. Somebody else is controlling.
Okay. No, that should not be. Let me try. This is 6 and I'm on 7 now. Are you getting 7?
No, sir. Sir, it's not showing that professor is controlling the slide. So it's in someone else's hands.
Who is doing all such nonsense? Who is doing all such things? Don't interfere with the slides. Okay. Please help us. Don't change the slides. Let me change. Okay. Now, once again, I've gone back to slide 6 and I'm just going to slide 7. Okay. Now, on the competition layer, there are three basic operations, namely competition, cooperation, and updating. Okay, as I told, this particular concept is the most difficult one. Okay, out of all the concepts I am discussing in the course on soft computing and knowledge-based system. So please listen to me very carefully. And as I told, whenever we develop the computer program related to that, in the year 2004, okay, we had a lot of problems. Okay, and we took around 6 months time to develop that particular the computer programming. Okay, because no textbook, no research paper could help me, in fact. Okay, so I had a lot of thinking, lot of discussion, and lot of success and failure before we could develop this particular algorithm. And I took about 6 months time to develop this particular the computer program. Okay, the reason I'll tell you, okay, because all your, once again, PPT has been changed, and if I do not know who is doing all such things, it is very ridiculous, okay? You people do not understand your problem, okay? And you are not going to help yourself as well as others. Let me stop here. Let me make the PPT ready. Okay. Then once again, I'll start. It is very surprising who is doing all such things.